It's been a long time since we've seen a lock screen bypass, but one has actually surfaced, and it works. It allows you to see contacts and pictures on a locked iPhone. Doesn't matter if it's on iOS 10.2, beta 3, the latest, or all the way back to iOS 8. So this kind of affects a lot of devices. Now, if you're unsure what a lock screen bypass is, basically, when you're on your lock screen here, there are many things you can access, like pictures or contacts or any information on your device that you wouldn't want somebody just to pick up and access. There have been ways that you can get around this. It's been shown a whole bunch of times. I've removed my fingerprint from here, so we actually have a passcode. And without wasting a lot of your guys' time, I'm going to show you how to do this. Just to let you know, I've practiced like 30 times to show you guys this video before doing this. I really hope I can do it all in one shot. And you will require a second device. So it doesn't have to specifically be an iPhone, but we need to call the device we're trying to get break into. So this device, passcoded, and we want to access its data without putting in a passcode or a fingerprint, which I've removed the fingerprint, so it won't let me in. Anyways, first thing you guys want to do, call the device. The device needs to be called. Now, I'm going to silence this because this is important. You have to hit messages and then custom. You can hang up on the device there, and sorry for all the noise. Now, I found it was best to put your device on a table because what we're going to do is we're going to turn VoiceOver on and we're going to tap in certain fields to activate being able to edit the two. So as you can see here, basically how we're going to access this is we're going to first be able to change this to. So we'll be able to see my contact list, all of my phone numbers, private things that I wouldn't want someone to see without my passcode. So, turn on VoiceOver.
Okay, I turned on VoiceOver.
Now you can see I'm using Siri here. So yes, this does require a Siri-enabled device, meaning that the user who you're trying to gain access to the device has to have Siri enabled. So what we're going to do, right up here in the two field, you want to get ready, one finger in the two field here, close to where the name of the contact is, and your second finger you want on the keyboard. And what you're going to do is double tap hold and then start tapping in the keyboard thing. Now you can see that didn't work. So that actually did, yeah, I'm pretty sure that did work. So what happens here is it allows me to actually edit. So it didn't work. Now you see how that popped up there? That means that I've activated this text field. So I should be able to. Okay, so here we go. We can see my contact list. It was not showing here. The best way to do this is to turn Siri off after you've gotten this to work here, where you can actually type in this field. Now, this field will sometimes change or sometimes not change, but we've successfully accessed that. So let's turn off VoiceOver with Siri. Turn off VoiceOver.
VoiceOver off. I turned off VoiceOver.
And you can actually hear Siri begins to screw up, so there was two voices instead of one voice. And that's how you can tell, too, if the hack is working. So we go back here, and what we're going to do is now I typed in C. So everybody in my contact list that starts with C would appear. What you're after is you're after these eyes. So you need to find a contact that shows you I with the I next to it. That's the information, and that's how we're going to get further into our phone. As you can see here, I have a bunch of contacts. They're all blurred out, of course, but I have a few that are selected. I had an issue doing this bypass because this device here only has like two or three contacts in it, and none of the eyes showed up. So I actually wasn't able to get into this device, and this device is on iOS 9.33 jailbroken. So let's jump further. So now we're accessing my contacts. We're not supposed to be able to do that. Let's see what else we can access. We can jump into this contact here, which is, actually, I don't even know who this is. Anyways, what else can we do? Well, if you go to create new contact, you can go add photo. Come on, add photo, choose photo, and boom, all of a sudden, we're into my photos. So here we can see all of my photos that I've taken on my device. I have tons of photos on here. So now anybody could just pick up my phone and start looking at all these horrible, ugly selfies of myself here. That's me, guys. So that's basically it. Now, I was playing with this, and I don't want to show yet, because I'm going to save it for another video, but in this section, if you're able to crash the phone, you should, in theory, be able to access Springboard, which is where your app icons and stuff are. Now, iDevice Help was the original person who discovered this, and apparently he has found a way into Springboard. So I'm going to keep playing with this. I have a feeling he's using a long text string, maybe in one of the fields here that we can input data, or maybe even going deeper and playing into the ringtones. There's got to be an area somewhere that's weak enough that you're able to crash this app that's running right now, and it would allow you into Springboard. So if I do discover that, guys, I'll post another video. But there you go. So that's how I got in. If you want to see it, we'll do it one more time just to show you. Oh, this one requires a password. Okay. So again, turn on voiceover.
Okay, I turned on voiceover.
So you can see there, I didn't do it right. So you can see there, it popped up, so I got it. I show my contact list. Turn voiceover off.
Voiceover off.
Turned off voiceover.
Siri screwed up. And again, I'm in my device, and I'm accessing areas Apple usually doesn't allow you without the passcode. So there you go. That's how you hack into your friend's, your girlfriend's iPhone. Sorry for this video. Thanks for watching, though, guys. Anything else I discover on this, I will definitely post a video again. We'll see you again next time. Cheers.